In this module, we're going to talk about the mobile app services. As you noticed, we've had a couple different types of app services that we can deploy, or different types of apps that we can deploy inside of Azure in a platform as a service model. So the first would be the mobile apps, and I'll show you through the actual portal here that we actually can see all. I have a couple of them provisioned here. If you take a look here, actually at the app type, you can see that we have API, we have mobile, and we have web app. So in this case, we're going to talk mostly about mobile, but the idea is that through app service, we can basically configure these things in a very, very similar manner. So with mobile apps, if we started to dig into it, what exactly is a mobile app? What are we getting from the idea of having an app be mobile? The idea is really that we can kind of facilitate making it much easier for you to provision these types of applications. So as you come as a mobile app developer, you might not want to have to go set up all the back end. So we're going to need some sort of repository potentially to store data. Most of the time applications need that. We're going to need some sort of communication mechanism, or how are we actually going to communicate, some sort of REST endpoint that we're going to communicate with. And that sounds, you know, easy on paper, right? If we have a REST endpoint and we have an iOS, an Android, or a Windows Phone app, it's very easy to hit REST endpoints. But those, if you've worked with that, if you've done development in that, you know that that's time consuming. You have to write wrappers for all those kind of things to do your calls and make sure when things fail that it fails, you know, gracefully. We don't want to just crash on a mobile device. So the idea is that Microsoft has created these SDKs, and I'll cut over to one of our areas inside Azure that I recommend you take a look at. And if you just go under our mobile app section, you can see that we have these little selectors here that allow you to pick which platform you're in. So Cordova being something that's cross-platform, JavaScript being the same, but then we have iOS and Android specific SDKs, as well as the Windows / Xamarin type model for like a universal type application to run on mobile. And so I recommend if you're getting started with mobile app development, you should come to this portal and take a look, because what the SDK is going to do is do that wrapper for you. So when you come into your application and say, I need to create a database table to hold some data about your application, this thing will actually walk you through and say, where's your SQL server? So when we set up the mobile app, we'll actually tell it where our data repository is. And then based on that, in our application, we just start creating tables. We start creating things that we need to store, and this thing will handle it for us, creating the API and making sure that the SQL server, in this case, it's using SQL in the back end, is actually just going to provision automatically for us. So that's one of the biggest selling points, I would say, for a mobile application. API applications, just to contrast a bit, API applications are really to help you provision out the API. So in that case, there'll be no front end. You're really just looking to say, hey, I want to stand up this API that I might want to have other developers hit. Or maybe I already have a client-side application, whether it's web or mobile, that's going to consume this API application. Important thing to remember is we have a thing called API management, which is totally different from what an API service is. So if we talk about an API app service, that's the thing that's actually doing our work for us, talking to our repository, surfacing data, doing our business logic. API management is really around everything else that goes on top of that. How do we give developers access to this? How do we throttle them so that they can't bombard our service with too many requests? All those different kind of pieces that sit on top of a first-class API that you might want to expose to the public. So that's kind of the clear distinction there. And then web app, if you're familiar with our website model, is really surfaced around how do we run web applications, whether they're .NET, Node.js, Java, whatnot. How do we just run our application up there in Azure? Now, one of the important things I wanted to point out here in a portal when you're getting into these things is one of the first things that usually happens when people start doing this is they say, this is great, I can stand up my application, everything works, but I actually need to restrict users based on a login, right? So we have this section here, and let me try to highlight this so you can see it. It's under the features section. It's called authentication and authorization. So in the past, what would happen is we would say, okay, you have your web app, you have to handle all the authentication yourself. So you'd have to go research the libraries, figure out how to wire those up. We have some abstraction libraries for that kind of stuff with ADDL to hit Azure Active Directory, but maybe you're hitting Facebook, or maybe you're hitting one of these other providers like Twitter, and you want to use their credentials for that. And so in those cases, you had to go research each one of those, and it kind of adds some friction to getting your mobile app running. Because as a mobile app developer, you don't really care so much about that. You just want to use it. Say, like, I just need to use Twitter, Google, Facebook, or Azure Active Directory. How do I do it easily? And so that was kind of the idea here is we created a section called authentication and authorization. And in here, when you turn this thing on, you'll notice a little dropdown comes out here. Now, what's cool is like you can come into each one of these providers, whichever you want to support. And this is all GUI-based. You can also hit it through the API, but we could say, hey, for Azure Active Directory, we have different management modes. So Express is going to say, here's what our what we're going to create. Here's the app it's going to create for us. So it's going to go ahead and create a new Azure Active Directory app for us. So again, just trying to remove friction. This thing will actually go out and create the Azure Active Directory app for you, scaffold everything out for you. You don't have to do any configuring there. You're just basically saying, here's my directory. I want to use people that's in it. We can do the same thing. Under Advanced, we actually get different options. So if we kind of know what we're doing and we've already built our Azure Active Directory infrastructure, we can plug our client ID and some of the URLs from there, our configuration, into the system and just go ahead and leverage it. We could also do some similar things with Facebook. Again, so if you've had some experience with Facebook, you can actually go in here and provision the app ID and secret. So you would go out to Facebook, set up an app, get those IDs and those secrets that we're going to put in here. And then from that point forward, you just plug your app into it. So there is one drop-down box here that says, hey, if the user's not authenticated, which one should we try? This is really lowering the bar because it's basically just saying, hey, I only want to support Azure Active Directory users. Great, you could select that checkbox, configure it to point over there, you're done. You could also, in your application then, as you get more familiar with it, and say, hey, I actually want to support multiple providers. I want to give them the option to use their Azure Active Directory, but also their Google or their Facebook or Twitter or whatnot. So in that case, you could basically enable a lot of these different configurations here, and then in your code, actually switch between them based on your UI. That would require a little bit of UI coding so that you can kind of handle that for the user. But the idea, again, is just to kind of lower the bar there, make it a little bit more simple for users who are starting to get used to this. The other idea I see is in enterprises, when people are spinning up web applications, they say, hey, I want to spin up like a dev environment or a testing environment, and I have a certain subset of users that just need to do that, maybe our testers. So in that case, you could actually turn this on. You don't have to do anything inside your application. So you just bring your application over, turn this feature on, tell it which group you want to actually allow access to, and you're off to the races, and it's locked down from anybody else that would try to use the app. So that's the wrap on the module for mobile applications, as well as compare and contrast to the different other app service models that we have in Azure.